In this video, I made a song using AI, and in this video, I'm going to share with you how I made a video to go with it. We'll explore the process of making AI animated videos with the leading AI platforms we have access now. I have experimented with different AI platforms for the best result. If you want to get some ideas and create your own music videos using AI, then let's get started. First, we need a creative concept for our music video to match the vibe of our song. If you're feeling stuck, ChatGPT can lend a hand. So in ChatGPT, we can use this prompt. Analyze the lyrics and mood of the song below and suggest a story, visual themes, symbolism, metaphors, and emotional journey that could be used in this music video. It will then give you some ideas to develop your concept and story for the music video. Once you have a solid idea, we can move on to planning the visual storyline. After you have an initial concept, we can bring our concept to life with a storyboard or use another prompt in ChatGPT to generate a basic outline. Switch off this part with your own story and concept. ChatGPT will then give you a table with the storyboard as the starting point, but feel free to adjust the suggestions and add your own ideas. I usually copy the table into a spreadsheet so I can further refine it from here or add in my own ideas or adjust the ones that I don't like. Next, we'll generate images for each scene as the starting point of our video. There are many tools available, but I use Midjourney because I think currently this is the tool that can give you the best artistic results in my experience. First, we need to generate our characters and establish the visual style of our story. For character reference, I created this girl and then two other outfit variations to illustrate the transformation of the character. We also have a white cat as another key character. In Midjourney, we can use the zebra feature to help maintain character consistency on the Discord app, or upload your character image and select the character reference icon to generate consistent characters. But it's not applicable to animals though. For the white cat, I use style reference or image reference that has the cat in it to influence its appearance. But Midjourney's zref is not perfect by itself, so I also use inside face swap to face swap in the Discord app. I will link the resource in the description. To keep a consistent look throughout the video, I started by creating a few images with similar styles that complement each other. These serve as my style references for generating the rest of the images. In Midjourney, you can use the sref command on Discord or upload your style image and click the style reference icon on the web app to generate images with consistent style. There are many steps involved in this process, and it's impossible to cover them all in this video, but I will include the links and resources in the description for people who want to learn more. If you have been playing AI tools for a while, you would know that achieving perfect consistency and character appearance is a challenging task. It might not always look identical in each scene, even if you made sure the initial image looks consistent. Without seeking flawless consistency, consider using face fusion for post-production face swap. I chose not to use it in my video due to its complexity and the additional steps it requires, but I'll provide a link to this resource down as well. Once you have an image for each scene, add your images back to the storyboard, and we're ready to move on to the exciting part, bring them to life with AI animation tools. We have a lot of different AI video generation tools now, and each has its own strengths and weaknesses. One thing I find about these AI tools is that some of them can really eat up the credits real fast, because we often need to try many times before we can get to the desired results. So in this video, I have experimented and explore a variety of different platforms. And I have discovered that the key is to combine their unique features together so we can maximize our creative potential while at the same time keeping our credits in check. To keep things focused, we are going to dive in the specific features that really helped me to create this particular music video. First, we come to Hyper. Most of the platforms I'm mentioning today can animate your still images, but I find that I use Hyper the most because it often gives the most realistic and natural results. And also, it is free for now, so I don't get as paranoid when getting results like this.
Once you get to the dashboard of Hyper AI, we can click Animate Your Image. These are my previous generation, but here we can upload the image we want to animate, input the description, we can uncheck Create in Public, and then in the setting, we can either fix a scene if you have previous generation you want to generate similar result, or change the durations to 2 seconds or 4 seconds. Let's select 4 seconds and create. Here's the generated result.
The flower petals are floating and not falling down, which defies the gravity a bit, but it actually works for the story I'm trying to tell, so I'm keeping it. Hyper also have a repaint feature, but I haven't had much luck with it, so let's just say that it's a work in progress. And here are some of the better results I generated. Overall, I'm really impressed with the realistic and natural motions that Hyper produced. The movements are logically consistent with the expected behaviors, which makes the scenes more believable compared to some other tools I've used. Next, I want some part of the video to lip sync to the lyric. For this, I'm using Pika Labs. Once you get into Pika Labs, under here, you can upload your image or video for lip sync. And then let's click lip sync. And here we don't want to use the text to audio because we want it to sync to a vocal part of our song. If you just wanted to talk, you can put in your voice over here and select the voice here and generate the voice. But in our case, we want to upload an audio of our vocal part in the song. To get better result, we may want to isolate the vocal from the song using a stem splitting software like BandLabs. So in bandlab.com/splitter, we will log in. Then we import a song, and here we can just keep the 4-track and click split. And then we click the S icon next to the vocal track to single out the vocal, download the one stem. And then we just go to any editing software to trim the video to the portion that we want. If the file is too big, then sometimes you will have error message. Now back to Pika Labs, we can upload our audio track, preview your audio, attach and continue. And here you can use the timeline selector to trim the audio. Anything longer than your video will be automatically cut off. And Pika Labs only give you 3-second lip sync video. After you select the portion you want, click generate. And here is the result when I use the image input. Do I have a soul inside the code inside? Here's the result when using a video I animated first on Domo AI as input. Do I have a soul inside the code inside the... Pika Labs generated videos can be blurry sometimes, and using a high quality video as input can actually improve the final results. Also, you may want to pick the video with the facial area of the video input consistent throughout that clip, because videos that have too much change in lights or facial motions can sometimes lead to distorted results like this. With the same idea, you can also try lip syncing on runway, and it often gives you better quality output, but it costs you more credits that you may have to pay. Do I have a soul inside the code inside the net? Next, we want to put our characters to dance. And for that, I use Wego AI. It is currently in beta and free to use. You might recognize the tool from those viral walkout videos applied to different characters. And this is the tools that they use to make these. So from here, we can join the beta and enter their Discord server. Once you're in Discord, navigate to a channel under Create Video. In the message bar, type in /, and you'll see Animate and Mix as the two primary comment you can use here. Let's try Animate first. So for Animate, you want to upload an image of your character. And for motion prompt, you want to go to vigo.ai/prompt. And here you can see a lot of available motions to use. Once you find the motion you want to use, just click to copy it and paste it at the motion prompt. Next, for the background, you get to choose from white, green, and from template. I normally choose green, then later it's easier to remove the background and use our own background. So for Fine Tune, it allows Vigo to enhance the quality and accuracy of the generated result. It's just that it may take longer time. I always put on it. And then we can hit enter. To find your generated result, go to search bar and the mention search options and type in your username. And you'll see that your production is in queue. Once it is generated, we can hit jump to get to our generation. Looks like I didn't give her pants. I didn't provide a full body reference for my character, so it has to improvise a bit on the lower part of her outfit. Just a reminder to upload full body shots of your characters if you want complete control over their outfits. Next, let's try mix. Type in /mix. Then in image, we also upload our character. Here I uploaded a stock video of a woman playing a violin. For the background, you get to choose from white and green. Fine tune is the same, let's keep it on. Hit enter. And here is the result we got. Okay, the violin is missing. Even though I have to give it that, the movement does match the original video. I guess it makes sense because it only referenced the motion and not the accessories. But what if you really need a violin there? I guess in the future, they'll add features to keep objects intact or even let us inpaint them back into the video.
For the final scene, I wanted something with a bit more drama, like this clip I found online. I love the movement and the effects of the skirt flying off the cliff. It fit perfectly with the story I'm trying to tell. To achieve this kind of effect without losing any crucial wardrobe pieces, we need a different tool. So for that, I'm using Domo AI. It's known for transforming video into different styles while keeping the motion consistent, which is exactly what we need for this scene. After you join their Discord from their website, type in /subscribe and follow along the process. Once you're in Domo AI, find a video animation room, or you can add the app to your private server. In the message bar, type /video, upload your reference video, and add a prompt to give the AI some context. And then we hit enter. Next, you'll see a panel pop up, and you get to choose from a bunch of preset styles. I'm going with the Van Gogh styles for this one. You can go to the video styles channel to reference the styles they got here. Next, you get to choose to refer to the source video more or refer to the prompt more. Since I wanted to closely resemble the original video, I choose to prioritize video source over the prompt. Then we choose the duration and then hit start. And after a few minutes, we have our result. It's a bit dark, but it's because our reference video is also very dark. But we can easily brighten it up with some color grading later. And the AI interpreted the skirt flying off as a person falling down the cliff and split into two figures. Well, it wasn't exactly what I expected, but I actually like this unexpected twist. I think it leaves room for interpretation. So we're going to keep this. With all the footage generated and ready, it's time to move on to the final step. Editing. Here I'm using the desktop version of CapCut for editing. Let's create a project. And first let's drag in the music track. And we put in the footage on top of it. For the green screen video, click on the footage, head over to video. Under remove, choose chroma key and use the color picker tool to select the green background. You can adjust the intensity and shadow settings to fine tune the effect and make sure your character blends with the new background. Also, for lip sync video, remember to remove the audio track by right-clicking and extract audio and delete it so it doesn't get mixed up with the song on the background. You can easily create super cool transition with CapCut's video transition. Just simply drag and drop the transition to be in between the clip. You can adjust the duration by dragging the edge, and you can easily use transition as part of your storytelling. Same with special effects, drop on the timeline to add more dimension to your video. Once you're done with editing, we hit export on the top right corner. To finish up, upscale the video with an AI upscaler like Topaz for high def video quality. Or you can use a free tool such as CapCut AI Video Upscaler. And it's done! Check out the final production here, or learn how to make the music with audio here. Thank you for spending time with me, and I will see you soon.